Hi, Natalie. It's such a great pleasure to have you here today to talk about Mimi Plumb's Landfall.
Hi, Kim. Thanks for having me. Well, my name is Natalie, and I am an artist living and working in Seattle, Washington.
First of all, I mean, the cover is just amazing. For me, it speaks of fairy tales, and it immediately transports me to a different time.
It's a nice contrast with what's inside the book, too.
So on her first text interlude here, she says, "I remember having insomnia for a time when I was 9 years old. My mother told me there might be nuclear war." So we're set in a different time. This is not a fairy tale, but there is certainly all the danger of fairy tales.
I love that there is so little context for this book, for all the images. They have so much breathing room. They don't even have any titles. I love looking at photography in that way where I can kind of use my imagination. And I think a lot of these pictures are just so ambiguous.
Mm-hmm. We have the scene of the motorcycles and then this, it looks like young girl, long hair, brushing her hair. And it's hard for me to avoid thinking of her as the narrator, this 9-year-old with insomnia.
Yes, of course. Just with that teeny tiny bit of information at the beginning, I definitely, as soon as I saw this girl with this long hair, I immediately identified her with a younger Mimi.
Mm-hmm.
I was looking at this picture and just the shape where you see the little peak of the house, it's actually kind of an inverted house shape.
Mm-hmm.
And there's something so strange about that house existing in this landscape. I mean, this landscape doesn't look natural to me.
So I think it also brings up the question of the meaning of the title. Where is this landfall? Usually you think of a ship coming ashore. But here it looks like land itself falling.
Yeah, there's so much tension in all of these landscape pictures. I also love this next picture with the man and the younger boy looking at what I assume to be the side of some kind of aircraft.
Mm-hmm. Or a ship.
Oh, yeah. Also, the landscape appears on the side.
It's perfect. And they have a nice shape within it, too. There's a lot of attention to sequence in these images.
Yeah.
Ah, yes. And a forest fire. I mean, these feel so contemporary to California. And maybe they always will be contemporary to California. You see drought and you start to think more about how landfall reflects on what we experience on the West Coast.
Mm-hmm. Everything in this moment feels so intense, especially with the wildfires that were so incredibly bad this year. But of course, it's been happening for a while. It just, we're starting to see the effects in such a more drastic way. I think it's interesting that I came across this book this year. Of course, it becomes a place for me to like also continue to project my own anxiety onto these images. But I mean, it's definitely there. Mm-hmm. They're just so loaded. And here she is again.
I read her as the narrator. Mm-hmm. And so it's important to get to see her face. And it's hard to tell if she's like getting dressed or getting undressed. It's interesting how caught in time she is.
Yeah, I was thinking the same thing. Also, the space is, it seems like she's in a hotel room.
Mm, right. Yeah, it's not a little girl's room. I mean, if we're imagining her as the narrator, the story of insomnia and then being told about nuclear war, it makes sense that this little girl grows up and is suddenly in an adult bedroom and doesn't get to play.
This picture, I'm assuming mother and daughter in a bed. I read it to be in a hotel room again, just because it's so sparse, I guess. Personally, I hate when it's so hot out that I have to sleep on top of the covers. That just makes me feel really uncomfortable and exposed.
Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm.
Seeing these two laying on top of the covers, it must be a super hot night. Being a photographer and a photographer who uses flash, I think I have maybe a specific experience with these images that she has made with the flash. Mm-hmm. But, you know, it leads me to wonder, like, what this scene looked like before her flash went off.
You know? Yeah.
But putting, you know, she's kind of eternally froze them in this, in this image where the lights are all on, but they're asleep. Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm. Which definitely adds to the strangeness. So I looked at this picture so many times, and then yesterday I was looking at the back of the book, and I was really scrutinizing the darkness that she exists in, and mm-hmm. trying to figure out where this image was taken. And I think I figured it out, and it's actually very surprising. I think she's in a bowling alley.
I thought that too.
Then that made me love this picture so even more.
Yep.
Because when you first look at it, I mean, I guess I just assumed she's in this like creepy old room. To come across that little bit of information, I guess it brings it back into reality.
Mm-hmm.
And it also just shows that Mimi has this, just like this impeccable eye for seeing and capturing these moments that speak to something so much greater.
I love how she braids pictures together like that, that later information kind of sparks a memory of an earlier picture, and that even if it's a book is a sequential thing, but we kind of hold all of it in memory. Mm-hmm. I love this set of images. We've got another quarry sand pile and a beautiful cutaway, a perfect triangle.
Mm-hmm. If you flip this image upside down, it really, I mean, it's an inverted mountain.
Mm-hmm. And then on the next page, you get an even more perfect inverted mountain.
Mm-hmm.
And then that's the last image in the book. I like that she reinforces the title here with Landfall, that the last picture shows that tenuousness of the landscape, or the way that these hills seem to be sliding and we can't tell up from down.
Mm-hmm.
Well, there it is. Landfall by Mimi Plumb. Thank you, Natalie, for looking through this book with me.
Thank you, Kim.